Hey guys, my name is Tommy Rosen, and I want to talk to you today about yoga and recovery from addictions, all addictions. I sort of lump them all together into one thing. For me, it might be drugs and alcohol. For other people, it might be sex. It might be drugs. It might be shopping. It might be gambling. It could be relationships. Anything, basically anything where you continually participate in a behavior. You do something that causes you harm, and yet you can't stop. You decide to continue to do that despite it has negative effects on your life. I call that addiction. And as I look out into the world, I'm definitely not one of those people that thinks everybody in the whole world is an addict, per se. But I look out in the world and I do see a lot of addiction around me. And many of those people are sober and in recovery from those addictions, and other people are not maybe even aware that they are engaged in things that are harmful to them and that other people might notice as being harmful to them, but they don't see it. Well, I teach yoga for a living, and I live in Venice, California, and I've decided about a year ago to teach yoga for recovery. And yoga for recovery brings together a lot of yogic techniques, meditation, breath work, moving the body, a really good sweat, strong workout. Brings that together with theories and philosophies with regards to recovery from addiction. And I find that yoga philosophy and philosophy of some of the 12-step programs really do run hand in hand, and there's a lot of similarities, and it's really an incredible thing, actually. So I've been running these classes since September last year, so almost a year, every Friday night at a place here called Yoga Co., which is a great yoga studio, beautiful. And we've had anywhere from one person showed up for our first one, which was pretty interesting, and then we had up to 25 people, and now we really get somewhere around 20 sort of ish people every time. And next week I'm expanding it to other yoga studios, and so I'm very excited to take the offering around a bit more. So yoga for recovery, the reason I feel it's necessary, first of all, is because people in recovery, I often notice, have a lot of other addictions that they're willing to deal with. That could be like sugar addiction, or you see a lot of people smoking cigarettes, or they're in really unhealthy relationships, even though they've put down maybe drugs and alcohol or their primary thing. When it comes to these other addictions, they're willing to let those things happen because the thinking is, well, I got past the difficult thing in my life. And so now, as long as I stay off of that, my life will be, you know, good enough that I can allow these other petty addictions to take place. What I found in my life is those petty addictions ended up making me unhappy. I feel like I went through many of them myself. And I wish I had had yoga and meditation as tools. I wish somebody had taken me aside and said, listen, your recovery will be so much better, so much quicker, so much more effective if you could learn how to meditate and if you had somebody to teach you how to do yoga. And so that's what I'm wanting to give to the world. And that's what this vlog is all about. So thank you for listening. If you want to learn more about yoga for recovery, watch my other video logs. And you can come to my website, TommyRosen.com. And look at my other YouTube videos. And especially, come to a class. Come to Yoga Co. on Friday night at 7:45 p.m. Or come to Five Point Yoga in Malibu at 5:30 on Sunday nights. Those are the two that we're doing so far. And yeah, well, thank you so much for listening. Rock on.